Now in this video, we will be discussing about examples for generation of a grammar for a given language. We have already discussed about this topic in very starting of the lectures of TOC, but there we discussed only two or three examples. Here we are discussing more examples which are very important from competitive exams point of view. So come, let's begin them. I hope you will note down each and every statement that I will speak. The question is, generate a grammar for the given language, and the language is set of all palindromes over A, B. This is a very important question. What is the meaning of palindrome? A string which you read from starting or from reverse yields the same result. Suppose you read it from here or you read it from here, it is same. So all the strings which are of these kind are palindrome strings. A, B is our alphabet set. That means all the strings will be a combination of symbols A or B. So what all palindromes can be formed using A and B? One is the null string. You can represent null like this also. Null string is always a palindrome string, a string with a single alphabet symbol. Suppose A is a palindrome, B is a palindrome, and strings like AA is a palindrome, BB is a palindrome, ABA is a palindrome, BAB is a palindrome, and so on. This is the set of all palindromes in. So this is our language. We have to generate a grammar that will further generate this language. This is our question. So what is a grammar? A grammar is a four tuple NTSP, where N is our non-terminals used, T is the terminals used, S is our start symbol, P is our production rules. I hope you have revised the formal definition of a grammar from my previous videos. So we have to form these production rules that will produce this language. So come, let's begin forming the production rules now. So for the first production rule, we start with the start symbol. We take start symbol as S. Now this start symbol can lead to null. This is one production for the null string. Or start symbol can lead to only one input symbol, that is A, or it can also lead to B. Now these three are completed. Now we have also to form strings like these kind, ABA or BAB. For these we have to define a production rule. Say S derives A SA or S derives B SB. That means you can put anything between two B's or anything between two A's, such that if you read it from reverse or you read it from start, it will lead one and the same thing. ASA means, suppose in the place of this S you substitute B, then string ABA will be formed, which is this. And in this BSB, if in this place of S you substitute this A from this production, S derives A, then BAB will be formed, which is this strings. Now for these strings AA and BB, for these strings consider this production, S derives ASA, then in place of this S you can substitute null, it will become A null A, which is equals to AA. And for this you can take this production BSB. BSB can be written as B null B, which is BB. So all the strings which are palindromes are satisfied using these production rules. These are five production rules that we have derived. All the strings are satisfying these five production rules. So that means the grammar that will generate this kind of language will have these production rules. So let's write down the grammar. Grammar is a four tuple in which first tuple is our non-terminals. Non-terminals are our start symbol, only one non-terminal. And then the terminal symbols A, B are the terminals used. And the start symbol is S, and the production rules are S derives null or A or B or A S A or B S B. This is our grammars NTSP, non-terminal, terminal, start symbol, production rules. Now you can verify using these production rules, you will get all the strings which are palindrome. So this language is generated. Now let's consider one more example. I hope this example was clear to you. In my next video, we will study about same kind of another example. Study that also very well. And if you have any doubts, you can comment in the comment section or just drop an email at the email address mentioned in the description of the video. Don't forget to like and share the video. And also, if you have not subscribed to our channel yet, please hit the subscribe button also. Thank you.